Hello, my name is Nadeem Ansari, Assistant Professor at IAS IPS Indore. Today's topic is chromatic number, which is linked to my previous TPS activity. In previous section, we designed the activity of graph coloring. Okay. Now, the outline of my presentation is, first, we recall the introduction to graph coloring, which we design in TPS activity. Next, we will discuss the chromatic number. Then we will find the chromatic number of cycle. We will find the chromatic number of complete graph, tree, star graph, and bipartite graph. Now, first, what is the graph coloring? A coloring of a graph G, which is consist of a set of vertex V and set of edges E, is a function V to C when cardinality of C is K. Now a coloring is said to be proper if adjacent vertices have different color. For example, it is a graph of 5 vertices. If you want to apply graph coloring on the graph, so see there is a triangle. There is a triangle which required 3 color to color the triangle because all 3 vertices connected to each other. Now there is another triangle. Of which 2 vertices already colored. In this triangle, 2 vertices already colored, like black and blue. So remaining vertices may be colored. We have to color remaining vertices other than the color of these 2 vertices. So we assign it a green color because there is no edges connected between these 2 vertices. This vertices and this vertices. So it may be assigned a green color. Now come to the last vertex, which is adjacent to 2 vertices, which is already assigned a color green. This vertex is connected to these 2 vertices, and these 2 vertices connected to these 2 vertices assign a color green, so it cannot be a green. So we assign a color black, which may be a blue also, since there is no edges swing around between these 2 vertices. So it is a proper graph coloring since we have used minimum number of color. Now, what is chromatic number? What is the smallest number of color is possible to color a graph is known as a chromatic number. That if we have n vertices of graph, so what is the number of color to color a graph? Suppose we have bunch of color, so only n color are sufficient to color a graph. But we are interested to a minimum number of color. The chromatic number of a graph G is the minimum K such that G is K colorable. Now we have K colorable. If we can assign one of K color to each vertex so that adjacent vertices have different color. If G is K colorable but not K minus 1 colorable, we say G is K chromatic. Now we will find the chromatic number of cycle. Chromatic number of cycle is either going to 2 or 3 depending upon the even cycle or odd cycle. Now we have example of even cycle. This is the graph of 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 vertices. If we color like red, blue, red, blue, red, blue, red, red, blue, red, blue, red. So it is up to last vertex. So last vertex, this vertex made the vertices of same color. There is the same color at the adjacent vertices of the last vertex. So chromatic number of even cycle is 2. Notice we have alternative color in even cycle. Now come to the another example. This is the graph of 5 vertex. This graph of odd cycle. So 1, 2, 1, 2, 1. So red, blue, red, blue. Similarly, it is up to last vertex. Last vertex meet the vertices of different color. In last vertices means the vertices of different color because the red, blue. So vertex is going to be different color from its neighbor. So vertex is going to be different color from red and blue. So chromatic number of this odd cycle is 3. Hence we conclude that chromatic number of cycle is either 2 or 3. Now come to the complete graph. Complete graph is there is an edges between every pair of vertices. Or you can say that every pair of vertices connected to every vertex of the graph. Now we will find the chromatic number of different complete graph. So first we find the chromatic number of this graph. It is the complete graph of vertices 4. Now there is edges between every pair of vertices. Suppose we give same color to any of two vertices of graph, but every vertex of the graph connected to every vertex, so vertex ends have same color, therefore we require four different color. So chromatic number of this graph is 4. Now this is the complete graph of vertex 3. It is the triangle we discussed earlier. Chromatic number of this triangle is 3. Now it is the complete graph of vertices 5. So chromatic number of this graph is 5 because it is the complete graph of vertex 5, and each vertex of this graph is connected to every vertex. So chromatic number of this graph is 5. Now tree. We have tree or simple graph. It has many property. One of the property is that any two vertices are connected by unique path. So how many color do you need to color tree? We start from this vertices. It assign a color 1. Now which is adjacent to two different vertices? This vertices adjacent to two different vertices. So you assign a color 2. Now this vertex adjacent to another two vertex. And there is no edges between this and this vertices. So we assign the same color of these two vertex. So we conclude that the chromatic number of tree is 2. So only two color are sufficient to color tree. Now alternate point of view, in every distance between two roots, it is going to be same color. Like that. It means if there is an even distance between two vertices, then the vertex have same color. For example, this vertex and this vertex have the even distance, so this vertices is going to be same color. But if there is a odd distance between vertices, so vertices have different color. Like for example, this vertices and this vertices have an odd distance between them, so these two vertices have a different color. So chromatic number of tree is 2. Now star graph. It is a graph of highest degree. One color is in its center and another color is remaining vertices. Since there is no edges swing around between this vertices. Now if there is an edges V1, V2, now there is edges between V1 and V2, then it becomes a triangle. So we require at least 3 color, but there is no edges between V1, V2, V3 up to Vn, and n vertices is going to assign a same color, hence chromatic number of star graph is 2. Now bipartite graph. As you know, bipartite graph, if it is a vertex set, can be partitioned into two subset X and Y, so that every edges have one end in X and one end in Y. Now if every vertex in X is joined to every vertex, then this is called complete bipartite graph. Now we have the example of complete bipartite graph. It is the vertex set of X, and in vertex set X there is a vertex X1, X2, X3, and this is the vertex set of Y, Y1, Y2, Y3. And every vertex of X connected to every vertex of Y. So bipartite graph requires two color. if upper vertices x1, x2, x3 are assigned a color green and below vertices y1, y2, y3 assign a color red, because no edges seem around between two upper and below vertices. There is no edges between y1, y2, y3 and there is no edges between x1, x2, x3. So x1, x2, x3 have the same color. Similarly, y1, y2 and y3 have the same color. So chromatic number of bipartite graph is 2. Okay, thank you.